Good evening. Welcome to St. Bartholomew the Apostle Church. We come together today in the presence of God to celebrate the sacred liturgy for the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. I invite everyone to please stand and share a greeting with one another. Please join in singing our entrance hymn, Come Christians, Join to Sing.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
I'm the new guy. Thank you. Father John left a letter for me, like presidents do for the incoming president, and he said that you're incredible. So I'm very grateful for you, and Father. Very grateful for Father John, Father Matthew, and to the staff who've been so wonderful, and to so many people. But we'll talk more as time goes on. More importantly, we're back here for the times this week with family, with friends, with people on the road where we haven't been kind or generous, where we haven't lived what Jesus wants us to live. Let's just take a moment and, in our hearts and minds, ask our Lord for forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you died to sin once and for all. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you were raised from the dead by the glory of the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are way to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring all of us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We praise you, we
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes, she has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward, and whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, everybody. So my understanding of what a homily is, what the priest or the deacon does at this time, is we take the Gospels, we take the readings, and we take our lives, and we put them together and say, what is Jesus trying to tell us? What is the church trying to tell us? And tonight in the Gospel in particular is a lot going on, but let's focus a little bit on this whole thing about losing yourself or taking up your cross. The reality is this, I don't know about you, I don't like to suffer. You like to suffer? There's maybe seven of you who don't like to suffer. The rest of you, I'm not sure what's going on yet. None of us like to be in pain or uncomfortable. But yet Jesus says today, if you lose yourself, you'll find yourself. What does that mean? It means every time we sacrifice, and if there's anybody who knows sacrifice, it's people who are parents and grandparents, especially people who are caring for people who are ill, whether young people, older people,
It's not easy. He says to us, when you die to yourself, when you lose yourself, you'll find yourself. Every time we sacrifice, we become more like him, more like Jesus, which is why this is like our primary symbol. Hopefully we all have one in our homes, because it reminds us every time we die, every time we sacrifice, we're becoming more like him. And that's what it's all about. When we carry the crosses of life, when we've got things going on with our kids, in our relationships, our bodies are changing. Every time something's going on, when we die to ourselves, when we sacrifice, we're becoming more like him. Now today I was coming up from the shore, grateful that I wasn't traveling south. And it struck me that I was anxious and feeling a little bit nervous, even though I've been here for the past couple weeks visiting and Father John helping me and Father Matthew helping. And until Paul came to me and said, you know, I'm going to see a family today who just lost their third son. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? And he was going over to help with the funeral. He said, would you like to come? You know, I think they'd like to be anointed. So I went over. And when I was there with them, I forgot about me. Because I can't even imagine what these poor people are going through. So as we gather here tonight, when we forget about ourselves, when we sacrifice for the people, we become more like him. And what happens in a couple of minutes here is we come to the altar. We receive Jesus himself, the bread, the wine. We receive him, our food from heaven, so that every day, in everyday things of life, when we're confronted with crosses, with opportunities to sacrifice, to forget about ourselves, we draw upon his strength, because I can't do it by myself. I don't know about you. And that's why we gather week after week, to receive strength, to sacrifice, to carry our crosses, to be more like him. So if you're bearing the weight of a cross, or if you've been called upon in the past days or weeks or months to forget about yourself, to help someone else, and you need strength, let's just take a quiet moment right now, and let's talk to him. He who died for us so that we might live, that we might have strength, that we might have this sacrifice here at Mass tonight, food from heaven. If you need strength to die to self, to carry your cross, and tell him. Tell him, Lord, this is heavy. I need your help. I need your strength. Let's just take the quiet moment now and talk to our God.
Dear sisters and brothers, let's profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was trusting that God hears us, that God knows where we suffer, that God knows that we need his strength. Let's, with great hope and faith, present our needs.
For the church, that we who have died with Christ in baptism may recognize our dignity as children of God and our duty to live out our baptismal call each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our new pastor, Father Andy Pracher, that God may bless this new chapter of his priestly ministry and that he may be warmly welcomed and experience the loving embrace of this parish community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation on the anniversary of its independence, that it may truly live up to the values on which it was founded, equality and justice for all, and ensuring life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness for all generations to come, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, that God will free those who are oppressed by authoritarian governments and turn hearts from war and violence towards peaceful resolution of conflicts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who seek freedom from poverty, crime, and injustice, especially the refugee and immigrant, may they be treated with compassion and dignity as beloved children of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our beloved dead, may they now enjoy rest from their labors and God's holy presence. We remember especially Anthony Novello, Stephen Drozik, and Peter Roglin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us continue to pray for Father John Palladino as he enters into a new chapter of his life and ministry. Let's together pray to our Blessed Mother.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
And we ask all of our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen.
There are two collections today. The second collection is for the Building Maintenance Fund. Please join in singing our offertory song, All Are Welcome, All Belong.
Bring your home.
brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. By sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Let us pray as our Savior has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and the glory of Jesus now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My biggest concern today was when I was raising my hands for prayer that I was going to belt Father Matthew in the head. That didn't happen. Thank you for your warm greeting. I'm overwhelmed by it and so grateful. I'm also grateful for people that I know here from a far different place and a million miles away from Berkeley Heights, my former parish, Little Flower. I want to thank parishioners that are here today. Thank you so much. Thank you for you. You gave me 14 great years, and I'm very grateful for you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and proclaim the gospel with your lives.
Thanks be to God.